By the end of 2024, the job landscape as we know it will be unrecognizable. AI is no longer on the horizon. It's at our doorstep, threatening roles across every sector, from firefighting to law, from software engineering to education. But this video isn't about the inevitability of AI taking over your job. It's about what happens in the aftermath of artificial general intelligence, AGI, a future that's closer than most of us are prepared for. As we pivot away from a world where work defines our sense of purpose, we're faced with profound questions about our values and our identity in a post-labor society. For a lot of people stuck on the hedonic treadmill of life, this is going to be a huge shock. In this video, we'll talk about exactly what all of this means for you and the one simple thing you can do right now to prepare for the coming future where work as you know it no longer exists.
Well, we used to look up in the sky and wonder at our place in the stars. Now we just look down and worry about our place in the dirt.
This isn't the first revolution humanity has faced. In fact, it's the fourth industrial revolution. Each revolution built on the one that came before it, and at the same time, dramatically uprooted traditional lifestyles, making the world smaller, faster, and more interconnected. Each one of these seismic shifts in our society was characterized with the dramatic reshaping of industries, making many jobs obsolete, while creating new ones in its wake. But the fourth industrial revolution is qualitatively different, and one of the primary reasons for that is the principle of emergence. The idea that when components of a complicated system interact, they become more than the sum of their parts. Artificial intelligence is rising in concert with other technologies. In other words, we aren't just adding AI to our existing toolbox. This new era is built on the foundations of the digital revolution, the era that we are now leaving behind. This amplification of technology fundamentally changes the game. We are rapidly approaching a world where human labor is obsolete. This will transform everything about human society and has the potential to raise global income levels and improve the quality of life for populations around the world. To realize this dream, however, we have to grapple with massive challenges, massive disruptions to the current systems and structures of power that exist today.
Yeah, but your scientists were so preoccupied with whether or not they could, they didn't stop to think if they should.
Our society, as it exists today, isn't built for us. The AIs that run large segments of our society today, the engagement optimizers of social media graphs, they are not aligned with human values. Think of a news feed that only shows you articles that you are likely to click on and the echo chamber that creates in your mind. By giving us exactly what we want, when we want it, they are taking away our agency and giving us nothing of what we truly want. More on that paradox in a bit. But before we get too deep in the evil corporations and their sinister AIs narrative, it's important to remember that these systems aren't even aligned with the corporate and political interests that created them. These early AI systems tended to optimize for a single metric, engagement. This is the classic way to realize the law of unintended consequences. So let's pretend for a minute that we all want the same thing, to create AI systems that mirror our values to create a better world. What values are important to us? What metrics do we optimize for when creating these AI systems? This is the problem of AI alignment. How do we as humans create something potentially smarter than us that cares about the same things we do?
The challenge is not to act automatically. It's to find an action that is not automatic, from painting to breathing to talking to falling in love.
One way to align an AI is through the process of RLHF, reinforcement learning through human feedback. I like to think of RLHF as a nun in a mid-20th century Catholic school who slaps a child's hand when they do something wrong. This is a gross oversimplification of the nuance involved in RLHF, but it illustrates the core idea in this process, that human trainers act as teachers and ethical guides when reviewing AI's answers. The dirty secret of all of this, though, is that this does not and cannot work as AI gets more and more capable. AI will be faced with moral conundrums that we as humans have no context for. Think of a superintelligence that has access to swaths of real-time human data. Target, with their advanced data analysis, already knows when someone is pregnant, sometimes before they know it themselves. The ethical decisions that surround a system connected to the deep data machine that is our modern society go far beyond what we can even begin to comprehend. Not only that, even the ethical quandaries we can comprehend, we don't really agree on. Think of all the highly contentious issues that exist in our world that I won't mention because I don't want YouTube's AI to bury this video. Let's just say one of them rhymes with smumortion. As AI infiltrates and becomes indispensable in ever more crucial roles in our society, how and what it thinks about the world starts to matter a lot.
This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
And this is where the moral graph and the idea of democratic fine-tuning, or DFT, come in. DFT is a democratic process that surfaces the wisest moral intuitions of a large population, compiled into a structure called the moral graph, which can be used to align a large language model. This groundbreaking approach, spearheaded by the Meaning Alignment Institute and funded by OpenAI, represents a significant leap forward in our quest to build safe AI systems that respect human values. The Meaning Alignment Institute is an organization whose quest it is to understand and codify, in engineering terms, what the good life is. If we relate this to something like Maslow's hierarchy of needs, we can think of this as attempting to understand the upper tiers here. One of the core questions the Institute asks is, what would an economy centered around meaning, values, and community actually look like? To start to answer this question, they surveyed 500 participants sampled to represent the US population. They focused on divisive topics like how an LLM chatbot should respond in situations like when a user requests advice on that topic that we didn't mention earlier. They found that Republicans and Democrats can come to agreement on values it should use to respond, despite having different views about the topic itself. Indeed, after participating, 71% of participants said the process clarified their thinking, and 75% gained substantial respect for those across the political divide. They were able to do this incredible feat by building out the Moral Graph, a graph database that aims to connect and understand human values in a deeply intuitive way, a way that mirrors how our minds think about the world already. In case you aren't familiar with graph databases, I'm going to give you a quick 10-second course. A graph is made of nodes and edges that connect those nodes. In the case of the moral graph, each node represents a value, while the edges between the values represent the context that defines how the values relate to each other. The context here is one of the key innovations that powers value convergence from people with wildly opposing viewpoints. For instance, when discussing parenting, one of the values that came up when researchers were building the moral graph was about instilling discipline into a child. There was this inherent conflict between getting a child to behave and giving a child freedom. But what was discovered is that both of these core values are connected and are really pointing to a deeper truth, the idea that we need to foster curiosity in our children. In other words, we inspire discipline in our children in order to give them the space they need to ignite their curiosity. Because ultimately, we want our children to feel empowered and to have agency in the world they live in. This is a level of nuance that only comes from something the researchers call moral deliberation. The research participants created this new value, and create is the key word here that we will come back to in a minute. They created this value not by having an ideological discussion, but by talking about their own lived experiences. This is another key insight and component of this research, the grounding of these moral and philosophical ideas in experiential reality. When we talk to each other in soundbites of highly contentious ideological dialogue, we cannot empathize with each other. We cannot connect on any fundamental level if both parties are busy defending their ideologic territory, the egoic idea of who they are. However, when we talk to each other about our own experiences and the ethical ideas and values that drove those decisions, we can begin to realize that actually, on a fundamental level, we tend to agree much more than we disagree.
Our lives are not our own. From womb to tomb, we are bound to others.
So what does an economy centered around meaning and values actually look like? It's in this current modern world, teeming with misaligned incentives, that we find ourselves at a crossroads. In the digital age, our networks have expanded far beyond the local to the global. Yet for many, the sense of belonging has diminished. We're more connected than ever, but at the same time, more isolated. The algorithms that curate our digital interactions prioritize engagement over empathy, clicks over connections. This paradox lies at the heart of our current social fabric, woven with the threads of immediacy, but lacking the depth of meaningful relationships. By leveraging AI to map out the intricate web of human values, the Meaning Alignment Institute has started laying the groundwork for a new kind of community, a new kind of society, one where connections aren't based on superficial likes or shared demographics, but on the profound resonance of shared values and beliefs. This process plays out with an AI that interviews you and attempts to get you to speak about the deeply meaningful and often ineffable experiences of your life. This AI helps you to articulate the meaning from your experiences and then discover the core values and beliefs in which you are deriving that meaning from. And as abstract as all of this sounds, this is active research that you can become a part of right now. This AI is implemented as a custom GPT in the OpenAI marketplace that you can speak with for free. The link is right below the like button. In graph theory, structures within the data aren't built. They emerge from the connections between nodes. The same is true for the social structures and communities that emerge from our shared values. Vibrant, supportive communities emerge from the simple but powerful connections between individuals aligned in values and purpose. This emergent model of community offers a beacon of hope, a counter-narrative to the fragmentation and isolation that define our times.
Good afternoon and welcome to the regular meeting of the San Francisco Board of Supervisors for today.
A practical first step in this direction is exporting this process for other use cases. Think of the local politics of San Francisco and their housing policies. There are a lot of competing forces with different lived experiences within that community. Imagine AI helping to garner respect across the political divide while finding converging values between parties. Now imagine an AI specifically trained and fine-tuned on the resulting graph of values built from this process. This is a new type of community with a new type of leader built from a place of empathy and understanding. And it only comes from each individual taking action to understand where their true motivations and desires lie.
You know what that means? It's Latin. Means know thyself.
Much of the foundation in building the moral graph comes from the work of philosophers such as Charles Taylor and Ruth Chang. These philosophers argue that the values and core beliefs that form our identities have no meaning outside the context in which they are born. In other words, There are no such things as universal values. You cannot talk about a value outside of its context in any meaningful way. This leads to a profound idea that our identity, what we think of when we think about who we are, is not a static entity, but a dynamic process shaped by our interactions, our choices, and the communities we engage with. We are an epistemic patchwork woven together by the social and cultural context in which we live. Our journey through life involves membership in multiple epistemic tribes, groups that share specific ways of knowing and understanding the world. These tribes can be as broad as our national identities or as specific as our professional communities. Each tribe imparts a layer to our identity, contributing its own set of values, beliefs, and practices. The interaction between these diverse layers is what shapes our unique sense of self. This contextual nature of values suggests that our identity is, to a large extent, not something we have or are born with, not something that can be discovered, but instead it's something that we build. Identity is a continuous negotiation between our inner selves and the external world. It's a negotiation that involves reconciling our personal aspirations with the expectation of our communities, trying to balance our individuality with the roles we play in society. This negotiation is not always conscious. In fact, the default mode for most people is to just go along with whatever role society has programmed them for. But as we stand here on the brink of massive change, that way of thinking, that way of being, cannot last much longer. Our identity unfolds through the choices we make, the causes we champion, and the values we prioritize. It cannot be understood in isolation, only in the larger mosaic of human society. And when we finally confront that truth and recognize the personal narrative that is us, the chapter in the collective story of our communities, we begin to understand that we are part of something much bigger than ourselves.
You have to let it all go, Neo. Fear, doubt, and disbelief. Free your mind.
Carl Jung, the famous Swiss psychologist, called this process the discovery of oneself, the process of individuation. This concept provides a valuable lens through which to view this journey. It reminds us that the path to a whole, integrated self is also a path toward a more cohesive society. As we engage with these AI-mediated processes of self-discovery and identity and community building, we participate in a larger process of societal individuation. Each person's journey contributes to the collective emergence of a society that values the individual's quest for meaning and purpose. By exercising our agency, we navigate the complex interplay between our internal desires and external influences, carving out a space where our authentic selves can thrive. The future of our communities, our society, and humanity itself hinges on the values we choose to embrace today and the connections we choose to foster. The question of our era is not how to prepare for the inevitable loss of our jobs, but instead, how to prepare for the beginning of our lives. What values do you cherish? What kind of community do you wish to build and be a part of? Real progress should be about more than economic growth or technological advancements. Envision a future where LLMs have a granular understanding of people's sources of meaning, and community-owned models help allocate resources and make recommendations to help people live more meaningful lives. This is an invitation to join a burgeoning movement of individuals committed to building a future where technology serves to deepen our connections, not dilute them, where communities are built on the unshakable foundation of shared values and mutual respect, not the never-ending rat race of acquiring ever more nuts for the winter. By engaging with this AI, by participating in this grand experiment of moral mapping and community building, you take the first step toward redefining the social landscape of our times. You become a pioneer in the truest sense, charting a course toward a future where community and connection take on new depth and meaning. But as deep and complex as all of this is, it's only one piece of an ever-growing jigsaw puzzle. In order to build these empathetic communities of the future, we have to rely on our ability to communicate with each other through language. And AI is forcing us to evolve in that regard as well. Watch this video next to learn about the unexpected ways in which our AI is evolving our language to shape our biology and our society.